Do you want to do analysis of coding skills of the candidates? Do you want to conduct online coding assessments in the programming languages like C, C++, Java, Python, C# or JavaScript? Presenting Eklavvya platform which can help you to conduct online coding assessments quite easily. You can conduct programming tests in 8 languages. You can save time associated with developer interview. You can define your own custom coding based assessment based on the requirement of the profile or based on number of years of experience of the candidate. You can easily eliminate long interview time and improve accuracy associated with the hiring. There is a facility available for automatic evaluation of the coding skills where you can evaluate candidates' ability to write logical code. You can filter out candidates with the suitable coding skills. You can easily save hiring cost associated with online coding test. Eklavvya platform provides highly user-friendly user interface in order to attempt online coding test where any candidate remotely located can attempt coding exam using any browser and in a secure manner. So you can easily save cost associated with the recruitment. You can filter out suitable candidate without any kind of bias. You can also empower tests with the remote proctoring approach where remote exam management can be done. Candidates can appear for exam any location and remote exam invigilator can do the monitoring activity or can conduct exam in a secure manner. There is also advanced AI algorithm which helps various anti-cheating mechanisms as well as advanced facial recognition mechanisms in order to conduct remote online coding assessments. Now let us check the demonstration of it. Now let us check how you can define the programming or programming assessment using Eklavvya platform. There is a section available in the question bank related to programming questions. You can visit that section and you can you must have defined subject as well as topics associated with programming test. Then already added questions related to programming will be shown to you. You can click on edit button if you would like to edit any specific programming details. So while defining the new programming question, you need to define subject topic associated with it. And then there is this area available for problem statement. So problem statement is nothing but the program description of the program. You need to write the description associated with the program. Then next step is example. So you need to provide one or more examples associated with that program. What should be the details, what should be the output associated with the program. Functional description is additional area where if your program has got complex steps, then you can describe those complex steps to be implemented in the program. Then returns is additional information where you need to write the what exactly that program should return as a parameter or as a text. So based on that, candidate will be able to understand what should be the coding criteria for the program. Then there is a option available for the difficulty level. Then there are options available associated with the programming languages. So you can define the, you can ask candidate to write a program in say C or C++, Java, C#, Python or Go or JavaScript or Kotlin language. So you can select the checkbox associated with one or more programming languages. And there is even facility provided if you would like to write some incomplete program associated with it. If you would like to write a couple of functions and you are asking candidate to write additional function to get expected output, then that facility is also there where you can type the incomplete program and ask candidate to complete the remaining program. There are various language options provided. Next thing is input test cases and output test cases. So in this context, you need to write the input test cases where a certain number of parameters, one or more parameters will be used as an input and program should generate expected output. So here output test cases have been written. And for each test case, you can define the certain marks. So here in this context, there are two test cases have been defined. First test case, if it is successful, then 4 marks will be allocated. And in case of second test case, again 4 marks will be allocated. So candidate, while typing the exam, while completing the exam, need to verify program against for the accuracy associated with it against those input test cases, and then it will be verified against the, it will be matched against the exact output generated by the program. So you can click on save button to save the program or programming question associated with it. You can again click on new button and start typing the new program. Now if you have defined the programming related questions in the programming question section of the question bank, next step is creation of exam. So while defining the exam, it is quite similar to defining any objective subjective type of exam, where you can define name of the exam, that is say programming exam. Next step is allow candidate to review exam, duration of the exam, say 60 minutes, whether you want to enable negative marking or not. Then in case of exam type, you need to select programming exam as a type of the exam. Then there are various configurable parameters which are quite similar to while creating objective or subjective exam, where enable a separate timer for each question, enable unique question for each candidate, that is question randomization, question shuffling setting is also there. Then if you would like to enable remote proctoring for the programming test, you can enable it over here. Then there is also facility available to capture candidate photo. If you would like to capture candidate photo while a candidate is attempting the programming exam after certain time interval, you can do the setting over here. Then if you would like to allow question navigation, then you can set it accordingly. Then you can click on next button, and in the next section you need to select the programming questions which are there, and if you would like to include those questions in the exam, then you can select, you can click on get marks detail. As you can see, there are one question of 8 marks and one question of 13 marks are available. So I would select those and I can add it in add section. So as you can see in my programming exam right now, there are 2 questions with the 21 marks. If I would like to add some more questions, then I can select suitable topic associated with it, subject and topic name, and then click on get marks details. So as I can see, there are one question of 20 marks and another question of 24 marks is available in the question bank. So I can click on that and I can select it. So now my programming test has got 4 questions of 65 marks. I can define say 20 as passing marks. Then as soon as I click on generate exam, my exam will be generated. Then I can visit either advanced configuration or I can go to the examination section. In the exam section, I can define additional instructions associated with this exam. And you can type it over here and click on save button accordingly. So online exam instruction will get added for the respective exam. So this way you can easily define online programming exam in the Eklavvya platform. If you have defined the programming related exam, the next step is defining the exam schedule associated with that. You can click on new button and select the, your name of the exam as programming exam and define start date and time associated with exam. So I want to conduct this exam on 26th of October at 6 p.m. and schedule should end on the same date, say 26th of October at 7 p.m. So I can define the exam accordingly. So here I am selecting schedule start date, schedule end date time and click on save button. As soon as I click on save button, my exam schedule associated with programming exam would be created in the system. Then I can assign one or more candidates associated with it to the exam. So here I can visit assigned to exam section, and then I can select my programming exam, and then I can select schedule associated with it. Then if you would like to assign candidates from the specific batch, you can select that batch name and you can click on assign by batch, or if you would like to assign this exam to one or more specific candidate, then you can select it and you can click on assign to exam button as shown. As soon as you click on OK button, your exam will get assigned to those candidates and message will be shown on the screen that you have assigned two candidates to exam schedule. So now let us try and understand how to attempt that online exam. Question will be shown in the questions tab. Question has got various parameters like problem statement, example, functional description and returns. So problem statement will provide you the detailed description of the problem or program to be written. Along with that, in the example section, there will be certain detailed description associated with the program. For functional description, you can refer the functional description section, and what exactly system should return will be shown over here in the return section. And then in the test cases tab, there will be various test cases associated with the program, where you can click on run button. So as soon as you click on run button, your test case will be executed by the system, and if it is successful, then green color will be shown. But since this test case has resulted in a failure, it is showing it has executed in 484 milliseconds and it is a failure. So you need to complete the program associated with the question and then you can run those test cases. So here there is a programming text area that is being provided over here. You can write the program as per your logic. And then you can, there is a facility available where you can click on run button. And as soon as you click on run button, you will get to know whether the test case is successful or not. So this is the way using which you can easily attempt programming test. So in case of online programming test, you might be asked to write a detailed coding program in various languages. So there is an option available to select suitable compiler. So in the current context, you can see there are options available for C, C++, Java, C Sharp, Python, Go, JavaScript and Kotlin. So you can select suitable language as per the problem statement and you write or compile your program accordingly. As soon as you write your program and if it is ready to be compiled without any compilation error, you can click on the run button. So this test case has been successfully executed in 890 milliseconds and green output color of the input output text has been shown as green. Similarly, there are various test cases which will be provided to you. So you need to execute all those test cases one by one. And marks will be allocated to you based on execution of those test cases. So in certain cases, four test cases might be provided. In some cases, five test cases might be there. So while compiling the program and executing those test cases, you need to ensure that you are running all such test cases. And based on that, you will get expected output. So this way you can move to the next question or previous question by clicking on previous as well as or next, save and next button. As soon as you are done with your test, you can click on submit test button. Then a summary associated with your online coding test will be shown. Attempted questions will be shown in the green color. Not attempted questions will be shown in the gray color. Attempted and mark for review will be shown in the blue color. Not attempted and mark for review will be shown in the purple color. You need to ensure that you have attempted all the programs. If you are not sure that you are not attempted all the programs, then you can click on no button and just ensure that you have verified and attempted all the programs as per the requirement. And if you are sure that you have attempted all the programs, then you can click on yes button. As soon as you click on yes button, your program will be a programming test will be marked as complete. Now let us try and understand how you can check the result associated with programming exam. You can visit candidate result section and select the programming exam and schedule accordingly. Here you can see the exam review report. So as soon as you click on exam review report, you can see the details of program typed by the candidate, along with it marks obtained by the candidate within the respective coding assessment. You can also do additional exam analysis as per your requirement, where you can click on that section and additional exam related analysis will be available to you. Similarly, you can also export the result associated with programming assessment using various reporting formats available within the system. We have been working with various corporates, multinational organizations across the world. We have conducted 20 million plus assessments and counting. If you are looking forward for the demonstration about how to conduct online coding assessment, then you can visit our website or write back to us for the free demonstration. We would be more than happy to demonstrate best practices associated with conducting online coding assessment. Thank you.